one of the greatest physicists, cosmologists, and mathematicians known to mankind is Stephen Hawking. Even though Stephen Hawking is no longer with us, his legacy lives on in the worlds of astrophysics and science in general. As we approach the fourth anniversary of his death, the James Webb Space Telescope is finally sent to space and ready to solve the universe's mysteries. The Webb Telescope has looked at a number of subjects, including his well-known theory. One of Hawking's theories got confirmed by the James Webb Telescope. His theory about the black hole is correct. But what is Hawking's black hole theory? What did the James Webb Telescope find out? And did it find anything else? Keep on watching to find out more. To understand Hawking's black hole theory, we must first know what a black hole is. A black hole is a physical phenomenon in which gravity is so strong that even light cannot escape. Because matter has been compressed into such a small space, gravity is extremely powerful. Whenever a star is dying, this can happen. People cannot observe black holes because no light can escape. They are undetectable. Space telescopes equipped with specialized equipment can assist in the discovery of black holes. Special instruments can observe how stars in close proximity to black holes behave differently from other stars. Black holes appear in a variety of sizes, but there are three basic categories. They are categorized depending on their mass and size, with primordial black holes being the smallest. This sort of black hole, according to experts, is as tiny as a single atom yet has the mass of a big mountain. Stella is the most common form of medium-sized black hole. A stellar black hole's mass can be up to 20 times that of the Sun, and it can fit inside a ball with a radius of around 10 miles. Within the Milky Way galaxy, there are thousands of stellar mass black holes. The biggest are known as supermassive black holes, which have masses larger than 1 million suns together and would fit in a ball the size of the solar system. Every huge galaxy has a supermassive black hole at its core. Sagittarius, the supermassive black hole at the core of the Milky Way galaxy, has a mass of roughly 4 million suns and would fit within a ball with a diameter of about the size of the Sun. We can't go to a black hole to see it for ourselves, unfortunately. The nearest black hole from us is far enough away that you will never be able to approach it. New black holes are discovered all the time, but the one nearest to us right now is around 1,500 light years away. It was given the name Unicorn and is found in the Monoceros constellation. However, if you go close enough to a black hole, it will drag you in and many things would happen to you at the same time, and you will eventually be ripped apart by the intense gravity. Stephen Hawking once said, "If you feel you are in a black hole, don't give up." Now that we understand what a black hole is, we can investigate Hawking's black hole theory. So what is Hawking's black hole theory? Hawking speculated in the 1970s that dark matter, the unseen component that makes up most of the mass in the universe, may be made up of black holes generated in the Big Bang's early stages. There, pockets of matter might reach the densities required to form black holes on their own, overloading the universe with them long before the first stars twinkled. Dark matter might be created by these primordial black holes, according to Hawking. While the concept was intriguing, most astrophysicists were more concerned with discovering a new subatomic particle that may explain dark matter. The black hole theory, which Hawking derived from Einstein's theory of general relativity in 1971, states that a black hole's surface area cannot shrink over time. The second law of thermodynamics states that the energy, or disorder, of a closed system must always rise, and this rule interests scientists since it is closely tied to another rule that appears to set time to run in a specific direction. Because the entropy of a black hole is equal to its surface area, both must always rise. However, scientists will require a huge telescope that can see beyond all current telescopes before they can test Hawking's theory. The James Webb Space Telescope, JWST, can help with this. The Webb Telescope finally launched recently, decades in the making and costing nearly $10 billion. The entire science world held its breath as the space telescope blasted off from French Guiana. It was so challenging that too much vibration during the release would have caused serious damage and doomed the entire operation. Because of its immense size, engineers had to compress it in several places to fit it into the takeoff rocket. The reflecting mirror, which is made up of many small hexagonal gold-plated mirrors, had to be folded because otherwise the 6-meter framework would not have fit into any current rocket. The heat shield, which is even more delicate, had to be folded as well. Despite its size, it comprises 5 layers that must be exactly aligned or the operation would fail. Each of these tennis court-sized layers is formed of a unique substance. The shield's purpose is to maintain it at the extremely low temperature required for the ultraviolet equipment to function. But, what did the James Webb telescope find out? The Webb telescope is still en route to its eventual destination, which is around 1 million miles distant. The Webb telescope will try to prove Hawking's contentious dark matter theory. As the name implies, dark matter is a substance that scientists can't see because it doesn't emit light or energy. Over 80% of the universe's stuff is made up of materials that scientists have never observed, and we only presume it exists because the behavior of stars, planets, and galaxies would be irrational without it. Dark matter is undetectable to the naked eye. It doesn't emit any light or energy, therefore regular sensors and detectors can't detect it. As said before, black holes are made of dark matter, according to Stephen Hawking. Three astronomers have now created a concept that not only explains the formation of dark matter, and also the appearance of the universe's greatest black holes. Priyamvada Natarajan, an astrophysicist at Yale University, said, "What I find personally super exciting about this idea is how it elegantly unifies the two really challenging problems that I work on, that of probing the nature of dark matter and the formation and growth of black holes, and resolves them in one fell swoop. This is only a model for now, but it's one that might be put to the test soon." After years of delays, the James Webb Space Telescope finally launched on Christmas Day, answering questions about the formation of stars and galaxies. The Webb Telescope will probably confirm Hawking's theory about black holes. All we have to do now is wait for the Webb Telescope to arrive at its destination. Did the James Webb Telescope find anything else? Yes, it did. We have received photographs from the Webb Telescope, which he has taken. The team completed the fine phasing step of mirror alignment on March 11, 2022. Despite the fact that Webb's first-of-its-kind optical system is still months away from being delivered, reaching this milestone implies the team is sure that Webb's first-of-its-kind optical system is performing as well as it can. However, the star from which the picture was taken, called 2 mass J17554042 plus 6551277, became the most well-known star outside of our own sun lately. That's because the Webb telescope, which was launched on Christmas Day and is currently 1 million miles away from Earth, picked an ordinary star to take its first photograph with its 18 hexagonal mirror sections in near-perfect alignment. According to NASA, Inverse, and others, Webb used a red filter to boost the star's brightness, and was able to view not only the stellar target but numerous stars and galaxies in the backdrop. So, after years of delays, the James Webb Space Telescope finally launched on Christmas Day, answering questions about the beginnings of stars and galaxies. The next generation of gravitational wave detectors is ready to expose a significant amount more about black holes, even primordial ones if they exist. With the help of the Webb Telescope, Stephen Hawking's theory about black holes and dark matter will very certainly be proven to be correct in the near future. So, what do you think about Hawking's theory? Are you excited to learn more about the secrets of black holes and dark matter? Let us know in the comments.